What's up, guys? It's Kelly, and today I've got a gel swatcher review for you. So today I am partnering up with Model Ones to share with you guys their two new gel nail polish kits that are in collaboration with the Pantone Color Institute. So these are kits that have everything you need to create a full gel manicure. We've got two different kits, two very distinct styles, and they're all these really beautiful Pantone-inspired colors. So here are the two kits. Each one comes with six gel nail polishes, a base coat and a top coat, a mini gel lamp, a nail buffer, and a file and tweezers. And then within each kit, we have some other extras. So the first kit is the Fierce kit, and this is your classic reds and pinks. And then three of the six gel shades in here are actually magnetic pigment. Of course, it does come with a double-sided magnet, so you can do a few different types of nail art looks with those magnetic polishes. And then we also have some gold 3D charms in here, and those come in a variety of different shapes. And then we have the second kit, which is the Emboldened kit, and this one has six really vibrant colors, and two of those six polishes are actually glow in the dark. And then we also have three different types of nail art charms in here. So we have these larger 3D nail art charms in a ton of different shapes and styles. We have circular rhinestones, again, multiple different sizes. And then we have these flat holographic square glitters. Also, the top coat in this set is actually a matte top coat. So yeah, I'm gonna go over both kits with you. I'll do swatches of all the polishes. I'll show you those special effects that each of them have. Like I said, these are gel kits, meaning they do not dry by air, they cure by lamp. Each kit does come with a mini LED lamp, which is what I am using for my swatches. So yeah, let's just dive right into those, and then I can talk a little bit more about pricing, availability, my thoughts on the kits. So roll the footage. So we'll dive right into it with the Fierce kit, which has your more typical classic nail polish colors. Three of them are cream finishes and three of them are that magnetic finish. So I'll start off with the creams. This first shade is called Raspberry, and as you can see, it's this really beautiful, juicy, reddish pinky color. I feel like this feels like a watermelon-y kind of color to me, and it's just such a classic nail shade. It's super gorgeous on. It was really impressive opacity, but I did end up doing two coats for full coverage, and it just looked so gorgeous on. It's just a classic color, you know? Next up, we have the shade Racing Red, which is a really beautiful red cream shade, and this one is a little bit deeper, which I absolutely love, especially for the winter and the holiday season. I just feel like this is the kind of red I gravitate towards. Instead of that like brighter, summery, cherry kind of red, this is like a deep wintry red, and I absolutely love it. The formula was really interesting on this one. It wasn't quite a cream, but it also wasn't a jelly. It was almost like a crelly formula. So it did give me really nice opacity. It covered up my visible nail line, but I did notice that it got a little bit deeper in the second coat, which I absolutely loved. So here it is in two coats, just looking really beautiful, and you'll see me kind of messing around with it because one thing that I love about gels is that you can really take your time. Because it doesn't dry by air, you can mess around with it for as long as you want, and then you can cure it when you're finally ready, and then you've got the perfect manicure. Next up, we have the shade New Maroon, and this is actually a really interesting color that I would say is pretty unique to my collection, definitely unique to my gel collection. And this one's sort of like this dusty maroon with like a purpley undertone to it, and I think it is just so unique and interesting. Again, we kind of had that crelly like formula, so it was a little bit more sheer in the first coat. Again, you see me kind of messing around with it because I just really like to take my time with gels. I feel like I want to take full advantage of the fact that it doesn't dry by air. But in the second coat, it did give me perfect coverage. It really covered up that nail line really well, and it looked super smooth and level on the nails. By the way, I don't know if I mentioned this, but all of the polishes are named and the same color as Pantone color swatches, which I feel like is so exciting because you really have an opportunity to just go absolutely crazy with the matching. So those were the cream finishes. Now moving on to the magnetics, and these ones are just really nice shimmery shades. So you have a few options with how you want to wear these. One, you can just wear them on their own, their full coverage in two to three coats. This one is called Sparkling Fuchsia, and it's just this really beautiful purpley pinky shimmer that has this really intense silvery shimmer running throughout. So you can use the polish on its own like this. You can use the magnetic wand over it and do a cat eye effect, or you can do that crystal effect. I'm actually going to show you with the last polish a different way to do it. The cool thing about using magnetic polishes in gel form is that they stay in their super magnetized state. So for me, as you can see, once I applied my magnet and pulled it away, the line where the cat eye was super sharp. And the fun thing is you can actually kind of mess around. If you don't love where the placement turned out, you can just continue to play around with it until you're satisfied and you don't have to worry about it drying. But once you cure it, it's going to be locked into that style. Moving on to the next shade, which is called Sterling Lavender. And I think that's just a really interesting name because that is absolutely the best way to describe this polish. It sits somewhere between being a lavender and being a silver. And it's just this really beautiful color. There's a little bit of like this softness to it, but then we have the intensity of that silvery color. We have that purple undertone. It's just so beautiful. By the way, I just realized I forgot to mention the third way that you could wear this is you can apply these over a black base and you can also get a really intense magnetized line of them. I think they just look really beautiful on their own, so that is what I ended up doing with them. And of course, I am into the classics, which is the cat eye. But like I said, in the next swatch, I'm gonna show you guys another option as well. And then again, the cool thing with gels is that you can kind of mess around, see what you like best before you commit to it and cure it under the lamp. And last but definitely not least of the Fierce kit, we have Satin Chemise, which, my goodness, I'm really glad that I Googled how to pronounce that one because I definitely would have pronounced that incorrectly. But this one is a really beautiful, very soft, very light beige color. And this one was actually really impressive opacity. You'll see once I applied the magnet, it just felt so strongly opaque, even in the areas that didn't have the magnetic pigment anymore. So I was just really impressed with that. But I wanted to show you guys a little bit of fun with messing around and trying a different effect. So I thought I would show you, I was messing around with the cat eye effect, but then I was like, you know what? Let me try that crystal effect. So basically just holding the magnet around the sides of my nails with the magnet facing down, and it kind of creates this three-dimensional, almost like velvety look on the nails, something that I absolutely love. So it was fun to play around with and see what it looked like, but ultimately I did end up doing the cat eye, and I could do that because I didn't cure it, so I could really just play around with it indefinitely. But here it is with that cat eye effect, and I just think it's really beautiful. So here are all the shades together, and I have to say, I really love this collection. I love these classic colors. I love the magnetic shades as well, and I just feel like these are all perfect holiday shades. I feel like this would also be a very perfect holiday gift. So moving on to the Emboldened kit, and this one is very different from the Fierce shades. This one has a lot more bright, bold colors in it. This first color is called Artisan's Gold, and as you can see, it's this really, really nice mustard yellow cream shade, and I definitely enjoyed this color. I love shades like this. I think they are so beautiful, especially in the fall, but I feel like you could really get away with wearing this color any time of year, especially if you want something just a little bright and fun. I thought it was fully opaque in two coats, but I get so, I don't know, nervous, I guess, about wearing two coats for a yellow nail polish, and I always find myself applying a third coat anyway. So I did do a third coat, even though it was already fully opaque, and I think I really did not need it. If I'm gonna wear this polish as a full coverage manicure, I'm just gonna do two coats. I think it looked absolutely perfect that way. I really didn't need this third coat, but I figured I would just throw it in here just to show you guys in case anybody else was curious. But yeah, this one's really beautiful. It had a really nice formula, and I was impressed with the opacity. I mean, my nails are short, so if you have long nails, you might need more coats. But for me, two coats gave me the perfect opacity. Moving on to the next shade, which is called Vibrant Orange, and I bet you could guess from the name that this color is a Vibrant Orange cream shade. And this one, again, was just a really nice classic cream color. I love orangey shades like this. Again, it's just kind of a basic that you should have in your collection, in my opinion. And this one in particular had a really nice formula. It was actually almost opaque in that first coat, but I did need a second to get full coverage, and I think it just looked really beautiful on. I was very impressed with this one. Next up, we have the shade Liatris, and let me tell you, I was incredibly excited to see a beautiful purple polish in this collection. This one is a really nice, softer, light purple kind of shade. It was actually a little bit sheer in the first coat, but it gave me full coverage in two, which I was really happy with. It's just a nice, soft color that I feel like is a classic any time of year shade. I feel like I'm saying that about all of these so far, but I mean, it really is. This is just kind of like a nice kit of basic basic colors that you should definitely have in your collection. Next up, we have the shade Directoire Blue. Now, this one I'm actually not 100% sure on the pronunciation because Google is telling me multiple different options and also telling me that I'm spelling director wrong. So I'm not 100% sure on this one, but it's a really beautiful cobalt blue shade. As you can see, I don't know what I was doing here with the application. I was getting a little messy. I figured I would try to like paint around the cuticle in a strange way. I don't know what I was thinking there, but you know, when you're working with gels, you can really mess around and nothing's gonna dry up until you cure it. So figured I would give it a shot. Ended up doing a normal coat for my second coat and it just looked really beautiful. It's a nice vibrant blue color and it's just a really nice formula. So now moving on to the specialty finishes in this set, we've got two polishes that are glow in the dark. Also, side note, these polishes are also black light reactive as well as the orange color. But this first shade is called Lovebird and it's this really intense highlighter yellow color. It almost has a little bit of this greenish undertone to it and it is so intensely bright and fun. It was a little bit sheer on application, which I kind of was expecting because that glow in the dark pigment tends to thin out a polish a little bit, but I did get full coverage in three coats and I was really happy with how it looked. It just feels like such a vibrant, bright, lively kind of color and that's in the light. But once I turned off the light, it was actually really hard to capture. I feel like these are brighter in real life, but here is what it looked like without any light on. And last but definitely not least, we have the shade Tanager Turquoise. Yet another name that I did have to look up. I feel like I am learning how to pronounce a lot of words today. And after I'm done with this voiceover, I'm probably going to Google what these words mean because now I'm very curious. But this one, as you could guess, is a really soft turquoise color. It's almost like that Tiffany blue shade. And this one, I feel like I could have gotten away with doing two coats, but because I knew that it was a glow in the dark shade, I wanted to make sure that I was getting enough of that glow in the dark pigment on my nails. So I did end up doing a third coat and I think it just looks really gorgeous on. I feel like I would never expect a shade like this to be glow in the dark. So it was a really fun surprise. And I think the really cool thing about this one is that the glow in the dark pigment is actually a little bit on the blue side instead of that classic green color that we see a lot. So that was really fun. Again, I feel like my camera just didn't pick up how bright it is, but it is very glowy. So here are all of the shades together. Like I said, a very different vibe from the Fierce collection. That was more of like the classic reds and neutral kind of colors, and this is more like the vibrant brights. But I think honestly, both of them are so good, really impressive formulas, really nice coverage, and just overall, I mean, I love the Model 1's formula, so I'm really happy with them. So yeah, those are the two Model 1's kits. And I have to say, I love the Model 1's formula. I just keep going back to them. I feel like they apply so easily and well. They're very beginner friendly. But the one thing that I love about gels especially is that you can really take your time playing around with them and working them around as much as you want. Because they don't dry by air, it can go indefinitely until you are ready to cure your nails. And I actually thought it was a lot of fun to play with those magnetic polishes in that way because I could really just mess around with them and keep trying different styles until I was happy and wanted to cure them. So that was definitely cool. Another thing that I noticed, if you guys have any experience using regular magnetic polishes, a lot of times over the course of you wearing that manicure, that sharp cat eye line is gonna fade out. It still has a really cool three-dimensional effect, but it's not as sharp of a line as when you first do it. With gels, once they're fully cured, it's not gonna soften that effect at all. It's gonna stay super sharp. So if you're a fan of that really sharp cat eye line, I definitely recommend going the gel route. But yeah, I also love this style of bottle that they do in these kits that they call the lipstick gel bottles. I just think they're really gorgeous. They feel super classy. They're this really like soft touch matte feel. I love that you can see the full bottle is the color of the polish within, so it's just really helpful. I just overall think these are great kits. I think they're great for beginners, especially if you don't have all the supplies you need. This is just kind of like a one-stop shop to get everything. But I think it's also really useful for travel. I mean, we have this really convenient little travel size kit as well. So like I said, each kit comes with these six polishes, the base coat, the top coat, the nail file, the buffer, the tweezers, different nail art charms, and then the LED lamp. Each kit retails for $46.99 USD on the Model 1's website. And I also have a discount code. You can use the code code KELLY10 to get 10% off your order there. So I'm gonna link everything down below. You can check that out if you're interested.
Hi, Editing Kelly here. I just wanted to jump in to also talk a little bit about their Black Friday deals going off. They're gonna have stuff up to 80% off on their website. So I'm gonna link their Black Friday sale stuff down below. But there's also a couple of exciting giveaways. So the first giveaway is that 10 customers are gonna be randomly selected to win a $50 digital gift card. So there's gonna be 5 winners chosen from any customer that shops between November 11th and November 20th. And then there's gonna be 5 more chosen for that $50 gift card between November 21st and November 30th. They're also doing a second giveaway. So the top 3 customers who place the most in an order between November 11th and November 30th are gonna get an additional $100 gift card. So I'm gonna list all of that info down in the description if anybody's interested.
But I would love to hear from you guys. What do you think of these 2 kits? Which color story do you prefer? Do you like the magnetic polishes better, or do you like the glow-in-the-dark polishes better? Let me know in the comments. We can chat about it. If you enjoy my swatch and review videos, please give this one a thumbs up. It lets me know I'm doing a good job. And if you're not already subscribed to my channel, please consider subscribing. I put out new videos every Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday. I'm also doing these Thursday videos for the holiday season. And I'm also on Twitch every Friday morning doing a nail art live stream. So I'll link that down below as well if you're interested in joining. Huge shout out to my Cosmic Admirals on Patreon, Amanda M, Braxton Scott, and Rocket Man's daughter. I really appreciate your support, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. Today's fun fact question comes from Patreon supporter Rocket Man's daughter, and Rocket Man's daughter wants to know, how do you store all of your polishes that don't fit in the rack we can see in the background of your videos? I'm looking for a way to organize mine so I can display them by color or finish so I can see them better. So this is actually kind of a tricky one. I do have this lovely giant rotating nail polish rack where I mostly store my OPI bottles on it, but the top row is usually whatever I'm reviewing or what I'm going to be reviewing. I don't know if you guys can see, but behind me, there are sets of drawers. I actually just recently, I don't know if you guys know this, but I do have a second channel, my vlog channel, where I just kind of post more behind the scenes, like real life stuff. So I'll link it up in the cards, but I just recently posted one where I swapped out all of my nail polish drawers for a new set of drawers. And the reason that I decided to go with drawers instead of open racks is because for me, I usually live in a place with a lot of windows, including right here. I have a window here. Generally, I think it's best to store your polishes in a cool dark area, and that's the best way to keep things from fading. I noticed that my OPIs tend to fade the fastest, and that's because the light does hit them. All of my polishes that are stored in the drawers tend to have a better shelf life. Now that's not to say that polish expires or anything like that, it just lasts the color a little bit longer. So that is my preferred method for storing everything. It's definitely a little bit more on the inconvenient side if you want to like see all of the colors you have, but one thing I see a lot of people do is put little round stickers on the top of each bottle, and then they have like a little swatch of the color on there. But of course, if you are in a place that doesn't have a lot of light coming in, I think it's totally fine to have nail polish racks as well. So yeah, kind of a non-answer there. I think it really just depends on the situation, what your personal preference is, and what your lighting situation is. For me, I just always prefer to keep them in drawers. But yeah, if you guys have any storage solutions or tips, you can also leave those in the comments, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.